Let's talk about Tony La Russa. Before we get into his latest DUI, let's go back to the White Sox deciding to hire him. The White Sox, to me, are a really fun team. They've got so many guys on that roster that are just flat out fun. You got Tim Anderson, Yolmer Sanchez, Jose Abreu, Luis Roberts. They're just a young, fun team. Like, this team is so close to getting over the hump. So what do? They're like, let's fire our manager. Bold strategy. They're really just one piece away from contending for the American League pennant. And apparently the White Sox felt like that one piece was 76-year-old Tony La Russa. But real talk, Tony La Russa, legendary manager. Guy's a proven winner. I honestly think this move makes them favorites to win the AL Central in 2008. I'm just as confused as you guys are. I don't get it. Not to mention, the White Sox are such a fun bat-flipping team, and Tony La Russa is not that. In fact, do you remember when Fernando Tatis gave that epic bat-flip against the St. Louis Cardinals in the postseason earlier this year? Like, everyone was like, oh my gosh, this is awesome. This is incredible. Well, everyone except for the Cardinals, obviously. They probably didn't enjoy that very much. But everyone else was like, this is phenomenal. That was the second best bat flip since Jose Bautista. Fernando Tatis just takes that bat and he just goes, I need that. Everyone loved it. Well, everyone except for 76-year-old Tony La Russa. According to the Washington Post, he said, and I quote, if you don't believe sportsmanship belongs in the game, you're full of Look, nobody is saying sportsmanship does not belong in the game. If you're pro bat flips, doesn't mean you're anti-sportsmanship. That's like saying fist pumping or you know, showing emotion after a touchdown is unsportsmanlike. Like, no, it's unhuman to not show emotion after something like that. Now, if you're like, man, that quote's pretty damning for a guy who was just hired back into the league. There's more. The reality of our sport is very simple. You're supposed to create entertainment for the fans the way one team competes against another. That's all it is. Well, I was always taught, and I do believe, there's a level of sportsmanship for the game and for your opponent that's at the core of competition. You don't abuse the game for personal value without getting too hoity-toity about it. If you're old enough to still be using hoity-toity in quotes, you're probably too old enough to manage in baseball. Just a ground rule. Yeah, it's just a ground rule I'm making up right here. If you still say hoity-toity in everyday conversation, you shouldn't be allowed to manage in baseball. Am I going too far in saying that? No, I don't think I am. Hoity-toity should get you banned from the sport for life, like Pete Rose. You should get the Pete Rose treatment if you use the word
hoity-toity
in conversation. I'm just saying, all right? The game is different. Everything's different now. Tony La Russa continues, to me, it comes down to respect and a sense of sportsmanship. Where do you draw the line? Again, it's not one or the other. It's not sportsmanship or no sportsmanship, okay? It's simply not. I feel like he realizes like how old he sounds while saying this. And now he's like trying to walk it back, but doing a really poor job of doing so. He's being very hoity-toity. This is the guy that the White Sox decided to hire back, okay? And again, don't get me wrong. Tony La Russa is a great manager. He's a winner. He knows how to manage the sport very well, even though he hasn't done it in 9 years and there's been a lot of rule changes since then. That's neither here nor there. He's a winner at heart. In fact, you want to know how I know he's a really good manager? He's already in the Hall of Fame. That should be another rule. If you're already in the Hall of Fame, like you can't come back to baseball. Like that's just, because if you're old enough to make it to the Hall of Fame, you're probably old enough to like be done with baseball. There's younger people wanting jobs. God love Rick Renteria. The guy managed his ass off this year. And what does he get rewarded with? A pink slip and having a grandpa take his job. And if you're Tony La Russa, why do you want to come back? You've already made it to the Hall of Fame. Literally the greatest achievement anyone in baseball can accomplish. Grab some Werther's, go sit on a rocking chair on your front porch. This sport is trying to change. It's trying so hard to change and it's trying so hard to get younger and better and more exciting. And then you go out and hire some guy who's like,
oh, bat flips are against the sportsmanship. Bat flips are so hoity-toity.
I just don't get it. I don't get it at all. But let's get to the reason we're all here. So Tony La Russa got arrested for a DUI. And DUIs are no laughing matter at all. If you're still getting DUIs, like really? It's 2020. There's literally a rideshare app for all shapes and sizes. You want Uber? You got it. You want Uber XL? You got it. You want Lyft? You got it. If you're oddly into clowns and you want a clown to drive you around, I'm sure there's a ride sharing app out there for clowns to drive you. All I'm saying is there's no reason to still be getting DUIs in 2020. Look, buzz driving is drunk driving. I don't know if you knew that or not, but it is. We've all seen those commercials. Everyone except for Tony La Russa, apparently, because he probably still listens to the transistor radio for entertainment. I'm pretty sure Bob Nightingale broke this story, and Jeff Passan wrote a follow-up with even more details to this story. But Tony La Russa got a DUI, and I haven't read the Jeff Passan story yet. I know, I'm a little late here. But I wanted to read it here with you guys. I wanted to just break it down, like, in person. Like, I know some of the things that he said. I've seen him on Twitter and stuff like that. But I want to break it all down here. Live. Chicago White Sox manager Tony La Russa is charged with driving under the influence after he allegedly ran his car into a curb in February, leaving it smoking on the side of a Phoenix area road. Oh yeah, by the way, this is his second DUI. He almost has as many DUIs as he has World Series rings. I want to break down the first one here in a bit. But the first one, he was found asleep at a stoplight. I love this. I'm only four paragraphs deep and we already found the most La Russa quote of the entire article. When reached by ESPN on Monday night, La Russa said, quote, "I have nothing to say," and he hung up the phone. That's La Russa right there. Hello? Jeff Passan with ESPN.com? I have nothing to say. I bet he slammed that phone down. And, like, you know it wasn't a cell phone because it's Tony La Russa. He slammed that phone, put it right back on the hook. In fact, it was probably one of these old phones. Hello? I have nothing to say. A White Sox spokesman said the organization was aware of the incident. That's good, because they clearly have no awareness in any other area. Let's get into the details. You ready for this? February 24th, 11:40 p.m. It's not even that late. Again, 76-year-old. For him, it's probably the middle of the night. But 11:40 p.m.? You know they say no good things happen after midnight? For someone Tony La Russa's age, no good things happen after 9 p.m. After a field sobriety test, La Russa was taken into custody in the affidavit. The peace officer described him as, quote, argumentative. Tony La Russa. Argumentative. You don't say. Wow. Information from the Maricopa County Justice Court shows that the case was filed on October 28th, one day before La Russa was officially hired by the White Sox. Okay, that's good. So the White Sox knew about this the day before they hired La Russa and were still like, yeah. I don't see anything wrong. Do you see anything wrong? Do you see anything wrong with it? No? We're good? We're good? I mean, who hasn't gotten a DUI, huh? This is the second? Who hasn't gotten two DUIs? This is the second time that La Russa has gotten a DUI. And after his first one in 2007, he said in a statement, and I quote, "I accept full responsibility for my conduct and assure everyone that I have learned a very valuable lesson and that this will never occur again." I believe it was the wise philosopher Justin Bieber who once famously said, "Never say never.
Never say never. Never, never, never."
I also love this detail from Jeff Passan. La Russa said he was returning from a dinner with, quote, "friends with the California Angels baseball team." The California Angels? Tony, that was like three name changes ago. When was the last time they were called the California Angels? 1996. 1996. Honestly, the officer should have arrested him right there. The officer should have arrested him right in that moment when he was like, "California Angels? What, how old are you?" 1996. The California Angels. Who is he getting dinner with? Darren Erstad? JT Snow? Sorry, I was just getting dinner with my friend Chuck Finley. I was wining and dining with Tim Salmon. Oh, officer, please. I was just a night out with Chili Davis. The California Angels. When the officer asked for identification, according to the report, La Russa continued instead to talk on the phone to a AAA representative. So the officer's like, "Sir, I'm gonna need to see some ID." And La Russa's like, it's fine. I'm on with AAA right now. Hang on one second. I'm on, hello? Yes, I need one of the tow trucks out here. Gosh, that's gotta be so annoying. I can't imagine what it's like to get Tony La Russa off of a phone. I mean, even when he's managing baseball games, he's always on the bullpen phone. The officer asked La Russa to exit the car for field sobriety tests. La Russa said he had undergone a hip replacement 4 weeks earlier and asked, "Why are we doing the tests? Why are we even doing the tests? Are you serious right now? You called your former employer the California Angels. That, I shouldn't have to give any other reason why we're doing these tests." He agreed to take the breath test, quote, "if it gets me out of here." Tony, one more thing. You've still got a flat tire, so you're not getting out of here anytime soon. In fact, if you take the breathalyzer test and you blow higher than a .08, you'll probably get out of here sooner, but in the cop car. The test registered a BAC of .090. The officer placed La Russa under arrest for DUI. When read his Miranda rights, La Russa said, quote, "I don't know my rights because you told me once I blow into that thing, we'd be done." Oh my gosh. What are you, 6 years old, Tony? No, you're 76 years old. The officer asked if La Russa had any drinks, and he replied that he had one glass of wine at dinner, the report said. Yeah. Tony La Russa is Italian. The last time he had one glass of wine at dinner was probably his fifth birthday. Before the arresting officer placed him in a vehicle, La Russa said, quote, "Do you see my ring?" When asked what he meant, La Russa answered, "I'm a Hall of Famer baseball person. I'm legit. I'm a Hall of Famer, brother. You're trying to embarrass me." Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. This might be worse than hoity-toity. "Do you see my ring? I'm a Hall of Famer baseball person. I'm legit. I'm a Hall of Famer, brother." Listen to me. If you're watching this right now, consider this a PSA. Never, never, never,
never
hit an officer with the, "Do you know who I am?" It doesn't matter who you are. That line has never worked. Like pulling Blake Snell in the sixth inning of a World Series game where he's cruising. It's never worked. So don't do it. Don't hit people with the, "Do you know who I am?" And then even when you do, don't say, "I'm a Hall of Famer baseball person." A Hall of Famer baseball person? You've managed in the sport for over 30 years, and you sound like someone who's never watched a game. A Hall of Famer baseball person? That sounds like, no offense to my wife, sounds like my wife, where she's like, "Isn't he a Hall of Famer baseball person?" Do you see my ring? First of all, which ring was it? Was it 89, 06, or 2011? I would hope it's 2011, because that's probably the biggest of the three rings that he owns. And it was the coolest one that he won. First of all, Jeff Passan, phenomenal work with this reporting. I'm so glad you brought this information to light, because it's so funny. Before we get out of here, can we go over the arrest video from the last time Tony La Russa was arrested? This is great. Let's watch this together.
I'm going to try and wake him up.
I'll do it now while the car is coming.
Put the car in park!
Put the car in park!
You know who this is? This is La Russa.
Oh yeah, I'm sorry.
Put the car in park!
He's getting pulled over in Jupiter, which is the spring training home for the Cardinals. Of course, the cops recognize him right away. You know, this is Tony La Russa. This is the manager of the Cardinals who literally play their spring training facility over there. They're literally pounding on the window, trying to wake him up. He's at a stoplight.
How you doing?
Good.
You alright?
Yeah. We found you asleep at the wheel.
That was a problem.
Well, yeah, you're in the middle of the intersection. So you come in from dinner with some friends, you said, and had some wine? Okay.
I had two glasses.
Two glasses of wine?
I got up at 6 a.m.
So you're tired as well.
First of all, Tony La Russa clearly counts his glasses of wine differently. Like, either he's drinking from this is one glass of wine, you know, like one of those Amy Schumer comically large glasses of wine, or one glass equals 2 to 3 glasses. So when he says 2 glasses, he means 4 to 6.
I mean, you can give me whatever test you want, I'll walk straight.
Okay, that's fine. So it's going to be 9 up, turn, and 9 back, heel to toe, counting out loud, arms down.
It's like the most boring episode of Reno 911.
Okay, you may begin, sir.
Maybe he wasn't drunk. Maybe he's just that old.
When I tell you to begin, I want you to close your eyes and tilt your head back. And I want you to recite the English alphabet from A to Z in a non-rhythmic manner. Don't sing it. Any questions about that? Okay, you may begin.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, I, Z.
M, N, I, Z?
R, S, T, U, V, V, Z, V, Z. T-U-V-X-Y-X-Z.
Okay. X, Y, P-I-X-Z. What was that? Hold on, I gotta hear that back again.
P-Z-Q-R-S-T-U-V. V-Z.
How many Z's are in the English alphabet, according to Tony La Russa?
Okay, Mr. La Russa, at this time, I ask you to turn around and put your hands behind your back for me, okay? Being placed under arrest with the charge of DUI.
Sir, 18, go with the traffic.
Honestly, I can't tell if he's in the back of a squad car right now or if he's on the front step managing a game against the Cubs. Like, that's the same expression he gives just all the time. I'm pretty sure that was the look he had after David Freese hit that walk-off home run in Game 6 of 2011 World Series.
There's a difference between being asleep at the wheel and passed out at the wheel. Okay. I would challenge passed out.
He's not wrong. There's a difference between being asleep and being passed out at the wheel. But I'll say this, Tony. If you have to get woken up from cops, and then when you get woken up by said cops, you can't recite the alphabet, I think that's a pretty good tell that you were passed out.
Today is Thursday, March 22nd, 2007.
This looks like a scene from like Paranormal Activity. Look, he's falling asleep again.
Can I hold this for you? Tight seal, low.
Three-time World Series champ right here, guys. Three-time World Series champ.
Can you feel the effects of the alcohol?
I'm just tired. I'm not going to walk to you right now.
I'm just tired. I mean, I could walk to you right now if you want me to. I couldn't say the alphabet 15 minutes ago, but if you want me to walk to you, I can do that.
You know what I do for a living?
That was my next question.
Oh my gosh! Do you know what I do for a living? This is the second time! That means when he did the whole... The ring. I'm a Hall of Fame baseball person. That was the second time he did the whole "Do you know who I am?" thing. Oh my gosh, this is embarrassing, dude.
Inner ear trouble.
Oh, I love this. Inner ear trouble. And then he thinks about it for a bit, and then he's like,
"Something a little lately."
Yes, lately.
I had a virus this before I came to Florida and fixed my vertigo a little bit.
It fixed my vertigo a little bit. That's okay. Sure.
I have a balance problem. It continues.
And it's been hard to keep my balance lately. That virus might be called Cabernet. So there you have it. There's your three-time World Series champion, new manager for the Chicago White Sox, Tony La Russa. This is, it's not a great start, Tony. Let's just call a spade a spade. You have a thing for getting into grandpa's old cough medicine, or I guess with you, it's just your old cough medicine. Tony, you gotta stop, dude. All your lame takes about baseball and how it's unsportsmanlike to flip your bat, that all aside, which I don't really want to push it that far aside because that's still pretty annoying, but these freaking DUIs, dude. Like, just don't drink and drive. If you're gonna drink, you're rich enough to freaking get someone to drive you. You could hire a driver, or at very least, you're rich enough to get an Uber every time you go out. Maybe. You seem to me like you go out a lot. All I'm saying is, I don't know what Tony La Russa is doing back in baseball. And I wish I could say the sport is better for it, but it's clearly not. But hey, congrats on being a Hall of Fame baseball person.